This is a favorite picture of mine. It's a painting by Claude Monet, Etretat, Sunset, 1883, February 5th, exactly at 4 in the afternoon. They've been able to determine when this was painted by the position of the sun and this cliff, which is real. It's on the Normandy coast. They call them the Chalk Cliffs, or the White Cliffs, because in the daytime, it also reminds me of Santa Cruz and a favorite beach up on the North Cliffs that I like to go to. Yeah, I love it. It's great. But I want to show you another picture I have. Not this one, but I'll show you this one while we're here. Flaunts Mucha, the moon. Just this gorgeous girl. Kind of giggling or something. Just being a little girl. Yeah, but here we have the crown jewel. Apollo 15, the first EVA, July 31st, 1971. Guys were walking on the moon. Give me a break. So listen, if you don't know about this, you should. Shame on you, because it's amazing. There's Dave Scott getting some pretzels out of the car. What a guy. Jim Irwin took this shot standing up here about where I am. At St. George Crater, I believe. And that big dark thing behind him, that's a mile-wide canyon. It's about 1,000 feet deep, called Hadley Rill, formed by a crushed lava tube. Billions of years ago, you weren't born yet. Over there is Elbow Crater, because the rill comes up the front of the moon in a sinuous kind of way, and it takes a nice right angle right here. So they named that crater Elbow Crater, because it's kind of on the elbow of the rill. There's the Hadley Delta, 15,000 foot Mount Hadley over there. The spacecraft actually landed over there as well, and then they drove the car around, parked it right there on this pretty steep incline. These guys were pretty daring. Talk about ballsy. Brass. Big balls of brass. I'll say it. So, if you've ever wondered where this actually was on the moon, because these guys all landed on the light side of the moon, not the dark side. It's a pretty impossible place to land a spacecraft. It's covered with craters, even more so than the front. This little guy, he likes to play with the moon down here. It's silly. And have you seen this on the internet? It's really cool. There's Dom. How are you, Dom? He says, I don't care. See you later. He's playing with his moon again. So, if we look at this, there's Tycho Crater. Big, huge impact crater on the front. You always see that on the bottom. And I've got this all backwards. There's the dark side of the moon. See, if I hold this, it'll go a little darker. It's really cool. You should pick one of these up. It was like 30 bucks. So, we've got the Mare on the front of the moon here. There we go. That's about how it looks in the sky. More or less. It tilts a little. The moon kind of wobbles. It depends when you're looking at it. It does this. But we always see this side. It does rotate, because if it didn't rotate, we would see the other side. Think about it. So anyways, so here's the Sea of Crises. Here's the Sea of Serenity. And here's the Sea of Tranquility. And we all know Apollo 11 was there. The Sea of Tranquility. And there's the Sea of Fecundity, one of my favorites. And then we've got the Sea of Storms over here, our Sea of Rains. And then so right here, the Sea of Serenity, you can basically pinpoint Apollo 16 down here, Apollo 11 here, Apollo 17 here, Apollo 15 here. So the Hadley Rill is right in this little butt crack between the Sea of Rains and the Sea of Serenity. This long rill that comes up through here. Right there, can you see that? The screen to focus. It's not really doing it, but that's okay. Anyways, wanted to show you that. Hey, little guy, there's your moon. Thanks for watching. Let's go find Dom. I think I see him.